Hi, Tom from Co-Creative. We're going to talk about two things today. We're going to talk about how to save a high-resolution image in Canva and which file type is best for this. Let's just jump right in and do it. All right, we have a logo here of a company we've worked with, and we're going to save it out as a PNG because that's the best file type to use. We're going to go into that in a few minutes. But firstly, let's save this out. So we go up to right-hand top corner and press Share. And we go to download. Now there's two things you need to do. First, click transparent background. We're going to show you why that's good. And drag 500 pixels all the way to the max, which is 1563 by 1563. And then just hit download. Now if we have a look at this download, here's one with the background saved as white. And here's one with the transparency. As you see, if I move it around the screen, you can see through it now, it's blurry. That's just because it's in a preview mode, but that means if you drop it onto any images, you're just getting your logo and you can put it as a watermark or do other things with it for social media purposes. Now, this isn't the best thing to do for any signage or anything you need to have infinite scalability. I do recommend that you save out as a SVG as well. Even if you don't have the ability to look at the SVG with the right program, so just come into SVG and save out as an SVG here. Now, as you can see, it says best for web design animators. It's actually best for any sort of design. So I recommend you always save that out as well. And we do go into that in a later video. Here's an artboard I've drawn earlier. This is a vector bottle I've drawn. Now I've saved it out as a JPEG. And a PNG, just to make the file size smaller and easier to work with. So when I save it out, if I don't need to do any more edits, it just makes the file size smaller, easier to work with. So the main difference between a PNG and a JPEG are the formats. The PNG uses a lossless compression that supports transparency. Obviously, this is the transparency. As you can see, you can drag over any image and it doesn't have a white box around it. And this means that there's no white background. There's a lot more to it, but simply JPEG, white background, smaller file size, PNG, transparent, a little bit bigger file size, but much better to work with. PNGs do better being compressed, whereas in JPEGs can get artifacting when they're compressed. So just stick with PNGs, don't worry about JPEGs. Now remember, when dealing with Canva, this is the largest file size you can save out. This is 1563 by 1563 on printed on an A4 page. As you can see, 300 DPI kitty, which is 300 dots per inch, barely takes up a quarter of the page. And if you're using a really good printer, that's how big kitty would be at 600 DPI. So as you can see, even at Canva Pro, the image size isn't massive. And this is why you need to save out an SVG. If you need a picture like this, much bigger than this, which is an actual picture, you need to start using design software like Adobe, Photoshop or Illustrator. But anyway, kitty's pretty cool, isn't he? Now, obviously, if I've forgotten anything or you'd like me to share anything in a later video, comment down below, subscribe, don't forget to like, and we'll see you in the next video.